Hey scientists, it's Kanisha again, and welcome back to the Science Studio. Check out this painting I'm working on. It's supposed to be a person. What do you think? Yeah, I guess there could be a little more detail. Maybe I should do some research about the parts of the human body to get a better picture of what we really look like. Oh yeah, I can see a lot more details in this book. More color, how body parts are shaped. Huh, what's this? A mirror? Why would there be a mirror in a book about the body? Do you think it's trying to tell us something? Oh, it's telling us that we can look at ourselves in the mirror to discover more about our own body parts and what they do. Let's look in the mirror and at pictures of other people to help us get this drawing just right. Okay, we can start from the top. What can I add to this big circle? What's that called? That's right, the head. And we can add some hair on top. Why do you think so much hair can grow up there? Take a moment to pause and think about it. Then we'll get back to it. Hair grows on top of our heads to protect the skin on our heads from the sun and the cold. You can see from these pictures that hair can be different colors and styles on everyone. So, if hair protects our skin, what do you think the skin does? Skin covers and protects our whole bodies. Like hair, skin can be different colors too. What else can we find on the head? Heads can have two ears on the sides. And the face, the front of the head, can have two eyes, a nose, and a mouth. All of these parts help us sense the world around us. We'll have to explore more about those later. Okay, what's next? We can add a torso. That's the part of the body with the chest, the abdomen, that's the tummy area, and the back. The torso protects lots of important body parts that are inside of us, and the rest of our body parts are connected to the torso. Oh, I'll need something to connect my head to my torso. What's that called? The neck. The neck also helps to turn the head up, down, and side to side. Beside the neck are the shoulders, which connect the torso to the arms. The shoulders help our arms twist around, a lot like how the neck helps us turn our heads. Another part of the arms that helps them move are the elbows. These are the joints that allow our arms to bend in the middle. And next, the hands are at the ends of each arm, which can have five fingers on each hand. Our fingers and hands help us to hold, grab, touch, and do so many other things. Okay, looks like we've got our upper body covered. What can we add to the bottom? Legs, of course. But what connects the legs to the torso? That would be our hips. But what exactly do our hips help our bodies do? Pause the video now, move your hips or watch a friend wiggle their hips and describe how our hips move us. The hips help us bend and twist our bodies. They let us move forward and back, side to side, and even spin a hula hoop. Now, what body part helps the legs bend the way that the elbows do with the arms. Yes, the knees. Knees bend our legs so we can run, jump, sit crisscross applesauce, and move our legs in many other ways. And below the legs are the feet. The feet work hard to keep our bodies balanced while we walk, dance, and move about on the ground. And lastly, what are those things on the tips of our feet that bend when we move? Oh, right! The toes. They're not as long as fingers, so we don't really use our feet for grabbing. But they do help us grip the ground when we move. Did you notice how the people in the pictures and videos all looked a little different? It's amazing how everybody is so unique. Okay, I think my painting is complete. What do you think? Looks a lot more realistic, huh? You can transform a stick figure into your own body in your science sketchbook. Your body might not look exactly like mine. That's because all bodies are different. That's part of what makes our bodies so amazing. Thanks for helping me with my artwork today, scientists. Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey.